My dear sister, I left you suddenly and without warning. For that and so much more to come, I apologize. I didn't board the Helios knowing what would happen, only that pursuing my research could change the world. And we did! Just not in the way I'd imagined. Not yet, anyway. I want to explain everything now, so that you'd see that there is nothing to fear. You've always tried to protect me, my big sister, but this was meant to be. It's now my turn to protect you, if only so that things unfold the way they are meant to. Time and necessity has kept us apart, but that is about to change. We need you here, aboard the Helios, with me. I've enclosed a receiver, and as the name implies, it can receive signals through which we will communicate. I know little of this will make any sense right now, but I also know that you will keep your promise. I love you. Your sister, Ada.
Pretty light on details there, Ada. You leave without warning, and now need me aboard the Helios? What aren't you telling me? Docking works better than these automated announcements. thought the great Helios would be more... busy? I guess Ada didn't tell anyone I was coming. Seems like I'll have to let myself in. Cliff, a company distributing electricity to half of the world and yet still hungers for that other half. Quarantine? What have you got yourself into, Ada?
Great!
Elevator up ahead. Thanks for the warm welcome. Now, what have you done with my sister?
Hello? Anyone there?
That should do it. Now to find Ada.
Archer calling any survivors on this frequency. Is anyone out there?
What the?
I repeat, this is lead researcher Archer calling for any survivors on this frequency. Is anyone?
Ada.
Rose?
Ada!
Holy shit, Rose!
Ada!
What the hell are you doing here?
Wait, what? Ada, you told me to come. I've got your letter right here.
That doesn't make any sense. I didn't write you any letter, Rose. But never mind. There's been an accident. Or sabotage. It doesn't matter. We need to get off this ship.
That's what the quarantine is about? Ada, what the hell is going on?
Rose, listen very carefully. We really need to leave. It's spreading all...
Ada! Ada!
The Helios, named after the sun itself, a source of almost unlimited power. This is a safe space for those with an open mind and a talent for the scientific arts to expand the limits of human endeavor. Away from prying eyes and cynical money men, here all that matters is progress as we reach for the very stars themselves. It is our floating home. And the cradle of mankind's technological evolution. You walk within the very future of the human race, and you are most, most welcome.
What sort of nut job builds a museum to themselves in their own house?
When I discovered the X-ray, we would have wonderful times in the lab shooting each other with the thing. Blackened silhouettes on the walls, capturing a single moment of playtime for all eternity. That is, of course, until we realized that X-rays are quite harmful. This machine makes the whole process much safer, though far less fun. My first Tesla tower at Warden Cliff was a huge success. I always knew that my dream of free energy transmitted wirelessly across the globe would be a resounding success. What I did not foresee was the hunger of the human race, its gluttony for more and more electricity. Wireless transmission of power, that's the easy part. Finding that power in the first place, now there's the tricky bit. Radio waves aren't just great for transmitting sound, images, and energy across large distances, but with this radio-controlled boat, they can also be used to transport people. If you're here on the Helios, then you've already enjoyed a voyage on one of these. They are unmanned vessels, controlled automatically via radio signals. Less risky in case of malfunction and subsequent drowning. Not that there was ever much risk. That is to say, you're safely here, aren't you? So? This is the machine with which I intend to rid the world of war, once and for all, my dear Death Ray. It may seem contradictory that such a thing could promote peace, but possessed with this, none would even consider military action against us. That's the theory, at least.
Scientists in the middle of the ocean. What could possibly go wrong? What the? Anyone? What the hell was that?
Yeah,
I can hear you, but what the hell am I doing here? If you didn't write the letter, who did? It's in your handwriting and everything.
This is gonna sound weird, but it might have been me. Not present me, but future me. I know how crazy that sounds, but I promise I can explain everything. Let's rendezvous in my apartment. From there, we'll escape together, okay?
Escape from what, exactly?
It's not safe here, Rose. It's spreading throughout the ship. I'll tell you everything when we meet up in my apartment. You need to grab a Faraday key card from the check-in desk there in the main hall. They're kept in a wall-mounted safe. The combination should be written down somewhere nearby. The key card will automatically take the elevator to the right district. Did you get all that?
Yeah. Open safe, get key card, use elevator, meet in your apartment. I got it.
Great. I won't be able to reach you on the radio for a bit, so just get there and stay safe, okay?
Fine. But when you get there, I'm expecting some answers. Deal?
Deal. Oh, and sis? Even if I can't explain why or how you got here, really am grateful that you're here. See you soon.
See you soon, sis. Must be the safe. Now to get it open? Bingo. A key card for the elevator. Right. Hope this works.
Ugh, what is that smell?
Another one? Locked. Great.
Rose, did you reach my apartment district yet?
Yeah. But this door won't open.
Easy there, champ. Try putting your considerable weight behind it.
Rose,
listen to me. You're having a panic attack. Just focus on my voice.
They've been butchered, Ada. Who or what did this?
We don't know yet. But right now, we need to get you safe. Make your way to the center of the apartment complex. There's a generator that will open the gates. Focus on that for now. I'm on my way. I'll broadcast to you again shortly. Be careful, sis.
I'll try. No Ada Archer listed here. Are these visions from the past? That must be it. Let's see about getting some lights on in here. Ada! Ugh, about damn time. What took you?
Hello?
Who is this? If you've harmed my sister, I swear to God I will break every phone.
I haven't harmed anyone, all right? My name's Aubrey, and it's really, really nice to finally talk to someone who isn't decomposing, you know? Never mind, sorry. But you have got to get me out of here. I'm holed up in the engine halls, starboard side, deck 82. Kind of trapped, actually. How soon can you get here?
Well, look, buddy, I can't make any promises. I'm going to get my sister off this thing, but if we can, we will come to get you too. How does that sound?
Oh yeah, of course. Don't mind me. I'll just sit here and starve. No problem. Benny died due to the exotic energy leak, but he still has most of his spine intact. Maybe he can lend it to you so that the next time a person in need asks for help, you will have enough of a backbone to actually do something. Ah.
What the hell was all that about? Exotic energy?
Thank you.
went without any time. Archer Ada. Aha! Alpha Quarter. Now, I just need to find a way inside. Listen, buddy, like I said before, we will do what we can.
Who are you talking to?
Ada! Oh, thank God. Yeah, some guy named Aubrey was broadcasting on our frequency. Said he was stuck in the engine halls and mentioned something about exotic energy? I'd like some answers.
Rose, I'd rather explain it in person. It's
no,
not
Ada, what you... Now is a great time to tell me what the hell is going on here.
Fine. I'll be brief. Listen. We discovered quantum resonance anomalies that prove the one electron theory, meaning that every electron in the universe is the same one moving back and forth through time. So, naturally, we began to consider a second time dimension attached to the Euclidean analogy of Minkowski space. Now, I know what you're thinking.
Ada.
What about the Thomson conjecture?
Ada, stop. It's me you're talking to. None of that nerd talk.
Right. Okay. A large experiment went boom. It ruptured a current of time and dangerous things have flooded through it. These things have been killing us. All of us. We've tried to contain it all, but the point is we need to leave. Did you find my apartment?
Yeah, but the Alpha Quarter is locked. I can't get in. Don't suppose you keep a spare key card somewhere.
Shit. No, wait! Yes, I do! My friend Eliza has a pair. God, I hope she's okay. She's on the ground floor, Gamma Quarter.
Gamma? Then our entrance is covered in a web of live electricity cables. I can't get near it.
Can you turn off the power source? The override code should be written in the Epsilon Guest Quarter.
Right. I'll get the override code and disable the generator. Easy peasy.
Listen, I'm entering another shielded section, so I'll lose my broadcast ability again, but I'll try to hurry. I'm getting closer.
Thank you. There we are. Override code 33212. Got it. Voila! Now to get Ada's spare keys. Aubrey King. Can't be that many Aubreys on board. Could there? What's going on? Rest in peace, Eliza. There we are. It is key cards. Let's go. Back to the Alpha Quarter. At least I know the way. Please work. Yes! Yeah, this is Ada's room, all right. Never did learn to clean her room properly. Taming a new kind of fire to raise mankind beyond its material limitations. You always did dream big, Ada. Oh, I haven't seen this picture in years.
Hey, Rose, where are you?
I made it to your apartment, and if we were to make it off the ship alive, I need to understand what's going on. For example, you said a future you wrote me the letter that brought me here. What does that even mean?
My research is about exploiting loopholes in the flow of time. So a future me will write that letter and somehow send it back in time to get you here on the Helios. Holy shit! And I think I know how! Listen, Rose, I need you to grab me some very important research. There's a secret room in my room. You find it while I make my way through another laboratory department. I'll give you a clue. It's center stage.
That's it. You're just going to leave me to figure this out on my own?
Have fun!
Aboard the Helios. We'll get together. We'll have a few laughs. So this is it? This is the research that will allow the letter to go back in time? I thought it would be thicker?
How's it going?
Pretty good. Although I'm afraid I found an error in your fancy calculations.
That would be the day. What did you find?
Well, you've got massless known vectors intersecting with relativistic spoon dimensions.
None of what you just said makes any sense whatsoever.
Makes just as much sense to me as this notebook. These equations will allow you to send the letter back in time?
Yes, and since you received it, I've technically already done it. Or will do it, depending on how you look at it. Comforting to know that I'll at least live long enough to write it. But the research means so much more. It could do so much more for all of us. Promise me you'll protect it. Promise me.
Fine, I promise. But now what?
I've divided the research into two pieces. You only have half of it. I'm on my way to pick up the other half. I'm just gonna go through the bio labs now and we'll... What the... Damn it! Rose, I'm trapped!
Our late arrival. A pleasure to finally speak to you, my dear. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Nikola Tesla.
I know who you are. Now go away so I can speak to my sister.
I am afraid that won't be possible. As I'm sure you are aware, the Helios is under strict quarantine, and for that quarantine to be effective, I cannot have you and lead researcher Archer be opening containment doors all over this ship. The damage already caused is severe. I cannot allow you to make it worse. Therefore, the both of you must remain at your current locations until this situation is resolved.
You are locking us up? We will be sitting ducks for whatever is out there.
Rest assured that I am doing everything that I can to remedy this situation.
Right. How's that working out, huh? A ship full of dead scientists, the great Helios falling apart at the seams. Where's your unlimited energy now? Coward. Ada, are you okay? Ada.
Hey, hi. Me again.
Oh. You. Great. First I get trapped. Now this.
Trapped? You too? Just like me? Well then, some expert advice. Finding what clean corner that isn't tainted with the stench of death. That's step one.
Not the kind of help I was hoping for. So you can get me out?
Well, that depends. Where are you?
The Alpha Quarter of the Faraday District. Some kind of lockdown gate came down. Can you open it?
About that. Can I count on you to come and help me out if I do this? My situation is slightly more complicated.
Aubrey, the door. Please. Pretty please.
Go get your sister, I understand. Family first and all that. But I've got family too. And I'm still trapped. Help me, and I'll help you.
Okay, Aubrey. Deal. Help me get to my sister, and we will come to get you too. I promise. Scout's on it.
Excellent. So I need you to stand away from the lockdown gate while I work my magic. Let me know when you found some decent cover, okay?
Holy shit, Aubrey! The gate nearly exploded!
Sorry, so sorry! My bad. I might have sent a bit too much juice down the power lines. I'll be back in a minute. Just going to run some diagnostics and high-five Benny. I think his arms should still be around here somewhere.
Sounds good. Nice work, Aubrey. I'll talk to you soon.
With a knife.
Can you take me to the biolabs while you're at it? That's where my sister is trapped. If she can't come to me, I'll go to her.
Just get to the rail station gates.
I'm at the gates. Get them open. Silently, this time.
Yes, ma'am. Here we go.
Who goes there? Stop!
Rose, I will have my revenge! You will pay for what you did!
You made it! Wow! What a sprint! I told you, Benny, she can run! Damn!